Hi. Now we have a retrograde, Basil. I won't tell you any information about this position. The only thing that I have for you is a question. What's on H4? There is a missing piece on H4. It could be a pawn, a bishop, a rook, knight, queen, and it could be either colors. Maybe it's white or it's black. Maybe it's a white bishop or black bishop, or a white pawn or black queen. It could be anything, but what I know is that there is absolutely a piece on H4. All the pieces on the board are in the right places, but there is one piece missing from this board on H4. This piece is on H4. So the question is, what's on H4? Try to look at this position and to analyze it. Then try to figure out what's on this square. First thing you must be noticed when you look at this position is that Black's king is in a check, currently in a check. So you could figure that it's black who has the move, who will play next move. But how this rook on d7 came to check the king? Where did it came from? There is no way. It can't be came from c7, sorry, or any other square. So how did this check happens? There is only one possibility to make it happen. Did you figure that out? Of course, if this rook wasn't here and it was a pawn, sorry, it was a pawn, a white pawn here, then it captures black piece here, then it promoted to a rook and he gives the black a check. Is that right? So the first information, or the second information, first information is that it's black's turn to move. The second information is that white has promoted a pawn on d8, right? And what else can you figure? Of course, because white take from c7 to d8, it takes a black piece. But what piece was it? Can you figure that? Well, it can't be a rook, right? Can't be a rook, because white will be in a check. And again, where did this rook came from? If there were a rook here, where did it came from to give white a check? It can't. Maybe if there were a knight here or anything, we could assume that the knight were here and it moved and gives the black a discovery check. But there is no knight here, or a bishop, or any piece that can move and give white a discovery check. So it can't be a rook on d8. And with the same logic, it can't be a queen. Where did this queen came from? To check white's king. Of course, don't forget white's pawn was here. So the queen can't check from this diagonal. Right? Where did this queen came from? It can't be a true thing to have a queen on d8, a black queen on d8. So maybe it's a bishop, right? Not a queen, a bishop. But look at black's e and g pawns. They are in their original positions. So how did the dark squared bishop get out from his original place to get to d8? How could that happen? He can't do that because his bones are blocking the way, right? So it can't be a black bishop. Maybe it's a white bishop, but of course not, because it's a dark square. So it can't be a light bishop. So could it be a knight? But we already have two knights. He has two knights already. Right? Now let's count black bones. It's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So black only missing one bone, and it can't be a bone on d8, of course. And we said that it can't be a bishop or a rook or a queen. So the only solution to this this problem is that it has to be a promoted piece, right? Maybe a promoted knight. Black promoted his eighth bone to a knight, or a promoted bishop. Maybe black promoted anywhere his pawn to a dark square the bishop, then it came here, then white took it and promoted to a rook, right? So now we know that black has promoted one of his pawns. That's a good point, and will help us to figure the main problem, what's on h4. Now remember the point that we talk about. White promoted to a rook, black is in a check, and black promoted to a minor piece, maybe a knight, maybe a bishop, right? But it don't matter. It won't matter what he promoted to, a knight or a bishop, because white took that piece and it came to the board, and now it's gone from the board. So let's think about the piece on h4. Could it be a black piece? Could it be a queen, a black queen? Of course not. If it were a black queen, then how did white take on d8 and promote? He is already in a check. right? So it can't be a black queen. Could it be a black rook? The same logic. It can't be a black rook, because if it were, white will has to move his king, not taking on d8 and promote. So it can't be a black rook. Could it be a knight? But we already have the two black knight on the board, right? Or white took one of the original knights on d8 and promoted to a rook, then it can't be a knight. Could it be a bishop? The original dark is called the bishop, but we said that it won't it didn't leave his its original position, right? And even if white promoted his its pawn to a dark squared bishop, then white, we said that white took it on d8, so it is not a dark squared bishop, and of course it's not a white squared bishop, and it's not a knight, as we said. And we said that we already have 7 black pawns on the board, and the 8th pawn, blacks promoted it. So it's neither a black queen, nor black rook, nor a bishop, nor a knight, nor a pawn, a black pawn. So this piece on h4 isn't a black piece for sure, so it must be a white piece. So which piece could it be? Try to think for this for a little. Well, the solving of this matter is harder than what we did till now. Now we figured out the easy points. It will get harder from here. First, let's figure out what is missing from white's army. White has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 pawns. We said that this rook is a promoted pawn, right? 8 pawns. So it's not a white pawn on h4. And white is missing one rook and 2 bishops, 2 knights and 1 queen, right? So it's 6 pieces that white missing. Now let's look at black pawn's positions. We know that this pawn was on b7 and it took white's piece on a6. Then now we know that black captures white piece on a6. That's useful information. And what about this pawn? Of course it came from f7 and it took 1, 2, 3 pieces from white's army, and we said that this pawn took one. Then we know where white had lost 4 of his pieces. And we know another thing. We said before that black promoted a knight or a bishop that white took with his pawn from c7, and he captures that piece on d8, right? So where did black promote? Look at his pawn positions. His A pawn on his original place. His B pawn is here. His C pawn, D, E, right? And his F pawn is here. We said that it captured three blacks, three whites pieces. And his G pawn is in his original place. So the promoted pawn must be an H pawn, right? And we said that white lost four of his pieces on E6, D5, C4, right? That's three, and the fourth on A6, that's four. Now we said that before white is missing six pieces, and we already know where four of his pieces are captured in. So we will figure out where is his two missing pieces. We know already that the piece on H4 is white, so it's one of these two. So we already has to figure out where black take the last piece from white's army. So black had a pawn on H7, and that pawn only captured one white piece, then it promoted, right? But why we assumed that it captured a piece? Couldn't that white piece had been captured by black knight or black queen or anything? Maybe. But did you ask it yourself? How did this pawn promoted? Where did it even go? How did this pawn promoted? Maybe like this, and again, it's blocked by white's pawn, so it must be took white piece on g2, right, then promoted on g1. But why is that? Why can't it be moved like here and take one piece, then again, then took another piece, then again, and promoted maybe on F1. Could that happen? Of course not. We already figured out where 1, 2, 3, 4 pieces, four white pieces captured in. And the piece on H4, right? That's five pieces, and white is missing six pieces, so this pawn must be captured only one piece, the left piece, right? So it must be happened on G2. He went straight, then take this piece, take a piece here, then promote her. But maybe you think that this white pawn isn't the original G pawn, maybe it's the F pawn, and it took black piece here, right? And that pawn which promoted here were the G pawn. Let's analyze this theory. If the G pawn is the pawn who promoted on D8, how could this happen? First, he take 1, 2, 3, 4 and advanced, then 5, right? And this pawn will take the 6, the 6 piece. So white pawns would have take, would have took 6 of black's army. But could that happen? Of course not. If you counted the black pieces, it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 pawns, 7 pawns and 2 knights. So black is missing 1 pawn and 2 bishops, 2 rooks and a queen. Exactly 6 pieces. But can white pawns take all these pieces, all the 6? Of course not. Why? Do you remember that when we talked about this dark squared black bishop, we said that it never left its original place because the E pawn and G pawn, right? So how white pawns, the white pawns took this bishop? It can't do that. So this bishop must be took by another piece rather than the pawns. Maybe white knight or a rook or queen or king, anything, but of course not a white pawn, right? So white pawns can't take 6 of black's army. So this pawn that promoted on d8 can't be the g pawn. It can't take 1, 2, 3, 4, then 5 and this 6. This scenario can't happen. But what can happen is this is a G pawn and it advances, and this is the F pawn and it advances, then take 1, 2, 3, and 4. And the 2 missing pieces from black maybe captured by any white piece, right? So this must be a G pawn, and white just moved it 1 square. Therefore, that H pawn must be moved from H7, H6, 5, 4, 3, then take on G2, then advanced. Sorry, promoted. Did you notice something from all that? All that black's captures? Let's remember where did black captures all white pieces again. First, on e6, on d5, on c4, right? And on a6, finally on g2, right? There were a pawn here and it take on g2, right? What do you see a common for all these squares? I can't put it in another color. I don't know how to do that. So I will just put white kings to make it easier for you. Here, black captures here and here, here and here, right? And we have a rook on d8. So black captures 5 white pieces on these squares. What's the common between them? Of course, they are all light squares. So what can you conclude from that? Or let me ask you a question. Where did black captures the dark squared bishop for white? Black can't do that. He can't do that in any of these five squares, because they are all lights, right? So I will just erase these weird kings and put the black pawns. It can't. So where is the dark square the bishop? Where is white's dark square the bishop? We said that black can't take it with any of his pawns, and we said that black only did five captures, and we know the place of every one of them. So now you must have been figured out what's on h4. It's of course a white bishop. It can't be any other piece. I hope that I was able to explain this problem. And if you don't understand anything from my explanation, you could ask me in comments, and I will try to simplify that even more. And thank you all.